Hey guys, it's Sarah, and today I'm gonna be reviewing Throne of Glass by Sarah J. Maas. It's more of a rant, really, not just a review, because I gave this book 2 out of 5 stars on Goodreads, and I have a lot of things to say about this book. Like, so many things. So, let's get to the rant, slash review. So, this book follows Selena Sardothian, hold on, I'm gonna put this book here. So, this book follows Selena Sardothian, the world's most greatest assassin, who's been enslaved for a year in the salt mines of Endovir in the Kingdom of Utterland. One day, the Crown Prince, Prince Dorian, shows up at the salt mines with the captain of the guards, and they take her away from the mines in order to make her participate in a competition to the death, which will make the winner the champion of the king, you know, to be his very own assassin slash killing machine. I have so many things to say about this book, mostly about Selena. Starting with the writing felt a little raw and just weird to me in places. It felt very... Now, Selena's supposed to be the world's most badass, notorious assassin. When I was told that it was a badass female assassin, I pictured Arya Stark. Badass. Instead, I was met with a Barbie who's pretending to be an assassin. All Selena cared about was pretty dresses, reading. Granted, what she was reading was about magical markings and symbols that were suspect to be the cause of murders happening between the competitors. Murders, mind you, that all of them happened off-screen. Don't even get me started on this one, because every murder in this book happened off-screen. I'm gonna talk about it later. And vacillating between falling in love with Dorian or Kale. Not once did I see semblance of a badass assassin. You know, I did not see daggers flying or heads rolling. Just nothing, none of it. And she has no assassinary skills or sets or frame of mind. I mean, everyone sneaks up on her. Everyone just creeps on her behind her back. I think this is what assassins are supposed to be, especially the world's most notorious, most dangerous ones. God. Selena, she was just so annoying, so irksome, so frustrating. And yeah, there were the tests revolving around the competition. We did not see Selena training. I mean, one scene or maybe two, and it was just, you know, a few moves here and there, and that's it. What? I did not like it. The only thing that we were shown are just being a Barbie doll. That's it. I wanted to see a badass female assassin. Even the tests in the competition were not up to par. They were just meh. This is what I have to say about Selena right now. We get to Dorian. I did not really care much about Dorian, although he was a bit of a creep a few times, sneaking up on Selena when she was playing the piano, which he had a point, though, in saying that she was some assassin. She did not notice him or feel him approaching her. He's a creep, but I agree with him on this one. In the midst of the killings between the competitors, he left her a bag of candy on her pillow. And she was stupid enough to eat it. There was no note, there was no nothing. Competitors were falling left and right, like flies. And she was like, oh, candy. No, no, no. It could have been poisoned. It could have killed you, you moron. She's a nuisance. I don't like her at all in this book. Granted, I am more attached to other characters. The next one is Kale, the captain of the guards. What annoys me about him is that he's the captain of the king's guard. And he's never killed anyone before. What's up with that? I mean, if I were king, queen, whatever, I would want the captain of my guard to be kick-ass, to be a person who's proven that he is fit for the position, for the job, to at least have killed a few people. I don't know, maybe I'm bloodthirsty, maybe, I don't know, but this is how I see it. He did not kill a single person, and the only person he killed in the book, because it obviously was his first kill, he went into, you know, to the story. Tests, they were boring, very challenging. Probably the only one that was a little bit on the tough side is when the competitors were climbing the walls of the castle to get the flag from the top. That was probably the one test that I really liked, because there was something going on, strength and, you know, because there was something going on, and I actually liked it. I liked that test. And every other test pretty much was just meh. Just so lame. They're supposed to be murderers and assassins and people on the dark side. And the winner is going to be the king's champion, the king's own killing machine. I would have thought that the tests would be gory and bloody and just not just lame. Okay. And the other point is that everything, the training was off-screen. The murders of the competitors were off-screen too. I mean, call me bloodthirsty. I wanted to see the killings. I wanted to see the torture. I wanted to feel the characters' dread and fear before they died. I wanted to see the how, the when, the why. I wanted to see everything. Instead, nothing. Too much tell and no show. Oh, and everyone, Selena, Dorian, Kale, the king, everyone was saying that Selena was a badass. Selena was the world's most dangerous assassin. Selena this, Selena that. And we did not see any of it. Once again, all tell, no show. In Selena's inner monologue, she would be able to kill that and to snap this person's neck and kill this other person and escape. It's all in her head. I would be able to do that. I would be able to do that. And just nothing. We did not see anything. It was just tell, 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 and no show. Not just not enough show, no. Zero show. It's frustrating. And then there's Cain. The character Cain. It was obvious that he was the one killing the competitors, because there was this scene when Selena, Nehemia, and Kale were walking around the castle, and they found Cain crouching on the floor, drawing markings on the floor, which later was discovered to be a cause of the murders. Obvious that it was Cain. It was so predictable that he's the one who was doing the killings. killing each and every competitor and stealing their powers for himself. You know, just physical strength, speed, cunning, whatever. It was him. It was predictable. The whole freaking time, it was just... they were going around in circles. Like, they don't know who did it. It's obvious. Sorry if this review was a little jarring and all over the place. It's my first review ever. So, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Please subscribe to my channel, and I will leave the links to my social media down below. And I hope to see you on the next one. Bye!